Hey everyone, in today's video I'm going to talk about dehumidifiers and whether or not you need one, and I'm also going to show you some of the products that I'm using. So a dehumidifier is basically something that removes moisture from the air to keep humidity low. If humidity is too high, mold can grow and mold can destroy the things that you have. So for example, if you are living in an area, a country with high humidity, and you have cameras around. Now I have cameras that have mold grow inside the lens, inside the viewfinder, and behind the LCD. So mold is a very serious problem here in Singapore, where the climate is hot and humid. So I definitely need to use a dehumidifier. I use watercolor, and after every painting session I will dry my box properly and open it up like this to keep it ventilated. If I were to close this box like this and leave it in the dark for maybe a few weeks, when I open it up again I will see white spots on the watercolor pens, even though this box has already been dried. But I will still see white spots because the moisture can seep in. And where there's moisture and when the environment is dark, that's the best type of environment for mold to grow. So I try to keep things that I have that are susceptible to mold attack ventilated. Have you ever opened a book and you find the pages, they stick together? Well, that's actually mold. Sometimes the mold can grow on the covers. You can see white spots or white patches. It can grow behind the cover. You may see yellow spots or white spots. On white pieces of paper, you may see yellow spots, and sometimes there is that smell as well. And if you actually go and touch the white patches, sometimes it feels a bit sticky. So those are mold, and obviously you do not want them on your books. When the pages stick together, basically it's very difficult to remove them, because once the mold attacks something, the mold will always be there. That book that you have, it will always be infected. So the best way to prevent mold is really to prevent mold from growing in the first place. So how do you know that the place that you are at has high or low humidity? The most accurate way to measure humidity is to get a hygrometer. This is an electronic one. So today's humidity, it was at 69% before I switched on my air conditioning. And now that the air conditioning is on, it actually dropped down to 44%. So what you want to do is to keep the humidity below 60% or even lower to prevent mold growth. And if you put this in your bathroom, you will see this number shoot up, because after you bathe, water is in the air, this number will shoot up. So it's good to have one of these, and these are actually quite inexpensive. So I have this in my cupboard together with this electric dehumidifier. This is a small one. There are much larger ones for rooms, but I bought this small one to put inside my bookshelf. And there is this water tray below. So after one night in the cupboard, just one night, it managed to collect this much water. This is maybe about 100 to 150 ml of water. So that's how much water is in the air that you cannot see. I'm actually not sure how this works, but that metal plate there, that's the metal that condenses the water, and the water will drip into the tray. So this electric dehumidifier, this is way more effective compared to the passive ones. Let me show you the passive ones. So this is a rechargeable dehumidifier made by Deerma. Hear that noise? Those are actually the bits that are inside, the bits that are supposed to absorb moisture. And you can see some of the bits here. So right now the bits are black, which means they can no longer absorb any moisture. And since this is rechargeable, I would need to heat up the bits in order for this to become dry again. And when it's dry, it's bright orange. This dehumidifier works, but it's not as effective compared to the active electric dehumidifier, which is constantly drawing in moisture. So if you are living in an environment where it's very humid and you put this inside your cupboard, it may actually turn black after one day, and it takes about 12 hours to dry the bits to bright orange. So after one day you have to dry it, so it's very troublesome to be always drying this daily. So this is actually a product that I don't really recommend. I recommend you get those charcoal that can absorb moisture, or those big bags of silica gel. I have a small bag here. This is great because it has all those beads there, and when it absorbs moisture, all these beads will actually turn into water. I'm not sure why they turn into water, but they will turn into water, which tells you that it's actually working. And this box has been in my bookshelf for a few days, and you can see there is some water inside. So you see that? It has collected quite a bit of water. There are many companies that make this type of product. You can go on Amazon and search for dehumidifier and you can see a lot. Check out their reviews. This is way more effective compared to this. This turns black one night in my bookshelf, and this can last for several weeks. The downside for this is plastic. It's not environmentally friendly. So once everything turns into water, you have to throw this away and you have to keep buying to replenish this. But this is way more effective and it does its job. So even though it has its downsides, I would recommend getting this over this. And if you have space or more money, get the electric one. That is the most effective. When you search online for dehumidifiers, chances are you're going to see silica gel bags like this. The advantage of this is small, so you can put this inside a small container. And if you do want to get this, I highly recommend you get those where you can see the colors of the beads, especially those that can change color when they absorb moisture. So for this particular bag, I cannot see the beads inside, so I have no idea whether or not this is still effective. So when you have beads that can change color, you know instantly when to change that bag. And there are silica gels that are colored. I'm actually not sure how effective this is because there's no way for me to know if this is actually still working or it has expired. So when you get those colored gel beads, when they are wet, you can heat them and you can use them again over and over again. If you have expensive equipment you want to protect, such as your camera, I highly recommend you get a dry cabinet. It's basically a shelf where it will draw moisture out. So I actually have several camera and lenses that I have in my dry cabinet. That is the best way to protect a camera like this, because once the mold gets into your lens will forever be infected, even after you clean the lens at the service center. And you may think of getting those silica gel bags and put them together with your camera inside a container. Well, my recommendation is to get a much larger container and put this inside instead. So this is way more effective compared to small bags like this. And again, you can see whether or not this has turned into water and when it's time to change this. So way more effective and very affordable. So my overall recommendation would be to go with this two rather than this two, or go with a large bag of colored silica gel. Now, I don't actually know the brand of this dehumidifier, but this is made in China. Anyway, if you do a search online, you will see a lot of different types of dehumidifiers. Many of them are made in China. Go for one with a larger water container. This is 500 ml, which is good for a cupboard that is around 2 meters from floor to the ceiling. So 2 meters wide from floor to the ceiling. This is good enough for that. And you would only need to change the water maybe after 2-3 weeks, because once it absorbs the water into the tank here, there is no more water in the air to absorb, so it will absorb less and less, so it actually can last for quite a long time before you need to empty this. Alright, let me know in the comment section if you are also using a dehumidifier and what you are using it for, and whether or not you have any problems with mold. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye!